Welcome students. In this video, we will discuss about latent heat. We know that whenever a material undergoes some change in temperature, it also undergoes a change in state. At boiling point, a liquid changes its state from liquid state to vapor state. And in melting point, a solid material changes its state from solid state to liquid state. Now, whenever the changing state happens, there is also another exchange of heat without increasing the temperature happens. And the temperature we should supply to change the state without changing the temperature is known as latent heat. Suppose a material is in solid state. So we want to change its state from solid to liquid. Then we can give external heat to it and the temperature of the material will rise up to the melting point. But when the melting point is reached, the material will undergo a change in state from solid state to liquid state. But during this process of changing state, the material requires some additional external energy to be fed to it so that it can undergo some change in state. And that energy which we should supply additionally without changing the temperature, that is known as the latent heat. So the amount of heat energy required to change the state of a material of unit mass without changing its temperature is known as the latent heat. So, the latent heat does not change the temperature of the material, but what it does, it just changes the state of the material. The unit of latent heat is calorie per gram. The freezing point and melting point, we all know that at a certain temperature, a solid material changes its state from solid state to liquid state, and that point of temperature is known as the melting point or the freezing point. Now, here is an example of the solid state of water, that is ice. Now, at 0 degree temperature, the ice melts into water, but if we closely look into it, then what we will find that at this temperature, when the ice melts, the water is also at the particular temperature of freezing or melting, that is 0 degree temperature. So the ice is at solid state having the temperature 0 degree Celsius and the water is also at 0 degree temperature, but the states are different. So, something is different in between these two. So, what is different? The difference is the amount of energy possessed by these form of material. In case of ice, the amount of energy possessed is slightly less and we are externally feeding some additional amount of energy, which is known as the latent heat, and that latent heat is increasing the energy of the ice and changing its state from solid state, that is ice, to water, into its liquid state. And the additional amount of energy is known as the latent heat. In case of water, the latent heat of melting is 80 calorie per gram. So, if we have 1 gram of ice, then we have to give additional 80 calorie of heat to change its state from solid to liquid at 0 degree temperature. That is the latent heat of melting, which is 80 calorie per gram. Now, these are the things that affect the freezing point or melting point. The type of material is the main aspect of freezing and melting point. different type of material possess different freezing or melting point. The pressure, the atmospheric pressure above the material is also controls the freezing or melting point. With increasing pressure, some material undergoes decreasing freezing point. In case of water, it happens when additional pressure is applied to ice, it melts at a lower temperature. The melting point then becomes 0.0007 degrees C, less than the normal freezing point. Now, whenever some foreign material is mixed with the solid state of the material, then also the material undergoes melting at a different temperature from its pure state. That is, in case of ice, if we mix ice with some foreign material such as salt, then what we find that the melting point of ice gets lowered and ice melts at a lower temperature, and that's why we find ice a little bit colder than the ice formed by pure water. So, presence of salt mixed with ice lowers the melting point. Boiling and condensation. If we further increase the temperature of a material, then at a certain temperature, the material starts to boil and changes its state from liquid state to vapor state or gaseous state. Whenever this changing state happens, an additional amount of energy, which is the latent heat, is to be fed to the material to change its state without changing the temperature. In this example, water boils at 100 degree temperature, but to change its state from water at 100 degree C to water vapor at 100 degree C, we need to provide some additional amount of energy, which is the latent heat, which is 537 calorie per gram. Amount of additional energy we must provide to change its state from liquid state to gaseous state, and this is the latent heat of boiling. So, this amount of additional energy is to be fed to the material. This latent heat is for water, but for different material the latent heat also changes. In case of water, 537 calorie per gram. Amount of additional heat energy we must supply to change its state from liquid state to gaseous state in case of water. Now, the things that affect the boiling point. The first thing must be the material. For different material, the boiling points are different. The material dissolved in the liquid is also affecting the boiling point. For different materials dissolved in the liquid, the boiling point changes from the liquid at its pure state. The applied atmospheric pressure above the liquid also controls the boiling point. In case of higher pressure applied to a material in liquid state, we have to increase the temperature further more than its regular boiling point to boil the material. This concept is used in pressure cooker. In the pressure cooker, the pressure is high. Which results in higher boiling point. water boils at higher temperature. That's why we can cook things at a higher temperature and we can cook fast. So that's how pressure controls the boiling point of different materials. With the increasing pressure, generally the boiling point also increases. Thank you. For testing your understanding of this lesson and more videos, log on to www.tubelessons.net.